There are two major covenants in the Bible that shape much of the Old Testament, the Davidic covenant and the Sinai covenant. Understanding these two main biblical covenants can help us better understand the Book of Mormon. The Davidic covenant was associated with Mount Zion in Jerusalem and included the idea that God covenanted with King David and his descendants that their royal line would last forever. This promise was seen as an unconditional covenant. The beliefs that grew up around this covenant, including the false idea that Jerusalem could never be destroyed, are known as Zion theology. The Sinai covenant is associated with Mount Sinai, where Moses met God and received the law. In contrast to the Davidic covenant, the Sinai covenant was conditional, in that the blessings promised were dependent upon the people's obedience to the stipulations given by God. Lehi, Nephi, and their descendants in the Promised Land clearly cherished and adhered to the covenant at Sinai, and greatly emphasized Sinai theology over Zion theology. For example, the name David is mentioned 1,127 times in the Bible versus 7 times in the Book of Mormon. Prophets in the Book of Mormon quote from Isaiah and Psalms extensively, but they seem to avoid the parts with Zion theology. They also draw more from Exodus and Deuteronomy, the stories of Moses. Furthermore, Sinai theology was associated with the Northern Kingdom of Israel, where Lehi's family originally came from. Why would Book of Mormon prophets favor the Sinai covenant? Lehi and Nephi knew and wanted to teach their descendants and future readers of the Book of Mormon that it is only when we keep the commandments of God that He will help us prosper in the land. That teaching was intrinsic to the Sinai covenant, in contrast to the common belief of Zion theology that all is well in Zion. Nephi and Lehi wanted to teach their readers that God's covenants are conditional, based upon our faithfulness to them. And now you know why.